Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Hayya ala salah. Hayya ala salah. Hayya ala falah. Hayya ala falah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Innal hamdalillah nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruh wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina man yahdihillahu fala mudilla wa man yudlil fala hadiya la. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika la, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayh. We praise Allah and we seek His assistance and we seek His forgiveness and we seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the evil within ourselves and from the evil of our evil actions. Whomsoever Allah, the mighty and the majestic, He guides, there's none that can lead Him astray. This is impossible. And as for the one whom Allah Ta'ala leaves astray, there's none that can guide him. This is also impossible. I bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped other than Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. He is alone, without having any partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad ibn Abdullah, he is His servant and His messenger. To proceed. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Oh, you who believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as He ought to be feared, and do not die except that you're in a state of al-Islam. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. O mankind, O humanity, fear your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah, who has created you from a single soul, Adam, and created from this soul, Adam, his wife, his mate, and produced from both of them countless, numerous men and women. And fear Allah, whom you demand your mutual rights, and do not cut off the relations of the wombs that bore you, for indeed Allah is the off-watcher over you. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ثم أما بعد. O you who believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and always speak the truth. If you fear Allah and speak the truth, He will rectify for you your affairs and forgive you of your sins. And whoever obeys Allah and His Messenger has achieved a great achievement. To proceed, فَإِنَّ أَصْدَقَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ. Verily, the most truthful speech is the book of Allah, Al-Qur'an. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم. And the best guidance, the most complete guidance, the most virtuous guidance from all of the guidance is the guidance of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم. والشر الأمور محدثاتها. And the most evil of affairs are those new names introduced novelties in Al-Islam. وكل محدثة بدعة. And every new name introduced novelty in Al-Islam is a بدعة, is an innovation. وكل بدعة ضلالة. And every innovation is a misguidance. وكل ضلالة في النار. And every misguidance will ultimately land the individual finding himself or herself in the hellfire of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أعاذني الله وإياكم من البدعة والضلالة ومن النار. And we seek refuge with Allah ta'ala for ourselves, likewise for our brothers, and likewise for our sisters, with regards to falling into misguidance, and with regards to falling into innovation, and ultimately finding ourselves in the hellfire of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. نفتتح هذه الجمعة المباركة الكريمة عونا من الرحمن الرحيم. We begin, we commence this blessed and noble Jumu'ah, ya ibad Allah, seeking the aid and the assistance of our Lord, the most merciful and the most compassionate. Dhakiran nafsi wa iyakum, reminding ourselves firstly, and our brothers and our sisters secondly. Amilan bi qawlillahi jalla fi'ala, working in conformity of the statement of our Lord, the mighty and the majestic, inda maqal, as he says, wa dhakir fa inna dhikra tanfa'ul mu'mineen, Surah Al-Dhariyat. As Allah Ta'ala says, and remind them of Muhammad, remind them of Muhammad, for indeed the reminder benefits those who believes. Surah Al-Dhariyat. وَيَقُولُ جَلَّ فِعُلَىٰ. And Allah Ta'ala also mentions, أُدْعُوا إِلَىٰ سِبِلِ رَبِّكْ. Surah Al-Qasas. And Allah Ta'ala also mentions, and call them, O Muhammad, invite them to embrace the path of your Lord. Surah Al-Qasas. وَيَقُولُ جَلَّ فِعُلَىٰ. And Allah also mentions, أدعو إلى سبيل ربك بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة. الآية سورة النحل. And Allah Ta'ala mentions سورة النحل, and call them on Muhammad, invite them on Muhammad to the path of your Lord using wisdom and a good admonition. ويقول ماذا وماذا ودعوة الناس إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى صفة من صفات المفلحين. And inviting the people or calling the people to their Lord سبحانه وتعالى is a characteristic, is a quality of the successful ones. أما سمعنا قوله تعالى. Have we not heard the statement of Allah تعالى عندما قال, as he mentions, ولتكن منكم أمة يدعون إلى الخير ويأمرون بالمعروف وينهون عن المنكر وأولئك هم المفلحون. Al-Ayah, Surah Al-Imran. As Allah Ta'ala mentions, and let there arise, O Muhammad, a group of mankind from amongst you, calling the people to the khayr, enjoining the good, and forbidding the evil. For indeed these individuals, they are the successful ones. They are the successful ones, ya ibadallah. Wa yaqulu al-imam al-kabir, al-hafidh al-jaleel, Abu Isa, Muhammad ibn Isa al-Tirmidhi, rahimahullah ta'ala, and the great imam, the noble memorizer, Abu Isa, Muhammad ibn Isa al-Tirmidhi, he mentions, ya ibadullah, fi sunanih, in his sunan, safhata 601, page number 601, haditha 2670, hadith number 2670, qala rahimahullah ta'ala, this great imam he mentions, qala haddathana Nasr ibn Abdurrahman al-Kufi, qala haddathana Ahmad, قال حدثنا أحمد عن شبيب عن أنس بن مالك أنه قال. This great imam, he mentioned that his sheikh Nasr ibn Abdul Rahman al-Kufi narrated to him, that his sheikh Ahmad ibn Bashir narrated to him, on the authority of Bishr ibn Madha, on the authority of Shabib ibn Bishr, on the authority of the great companion Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, said one day, Atan Nabiya sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam rajulun, that a man came to the Messenger of Allah one day, alayhi salatu salam, yastahmiluhu, seeking to inquire from the Messenger of Allah a mount for his riding beast. فَلَمْ يَجِدْ عِنْدَهُ مَا يَحْمِلُهُ. But the Messenger of Allah did not have with him to give the man for a riding beast. فَأَتَاهُ عَلَى الْآخَرِ فَحَمِلَهُ. For the Messenger of Allah instructed the man, directed the man, guided the man to go to someone else, to go to the other individual. فَحَمِلَهُ. And thus this man gave the man who was inquiring a mount for his riding beast, he gave the man a mount. فأتى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فأخبره. So then the man came back to the messenger of Allah فأخبره, and he told the messenger of Allah what happened. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, so the prophet of Allah said to the man, إن الدال على الخير كفاعله. Then the messenger of Allah went on to mention a tremendous hadith. He said, the one who guides or leads or instructs someone to some guidance or to some goodness, he gets the reward of the one who did the action. Ya ibadallah, فَلِهَذَا أُذَكِّرُ نَفْسِي وَإِيَّاكُمْ. So for this reason I advise, or I recommend, or I advise, or I remind myself rather, and my brothers and my sister, secondly, من مقام عظيم, from a tremendous platform, في يوم عظيم, on a tremendous day, عن حديث عظيم, with regards to a tremendous hadith, يا عباد الله. وهذا الحديث الذي قد ذكره الإمام الترمذي رحمه الله في السنن. And this hadith that, by the permission of Allah, we're going to discuss, has been narrated by the noble Imam Abu Isa, Muhammad ibn Isa al-Tirmidhi, in his sunan. Safhata 600. وثلاث, page number 603, حديث ألفين وستمائة وستة وسبعين, حديث number 2676, حديث number 2676, باب ما جاء في الأخذ بالسنة واجتناب البدع, chapter holding on to the sunnah of the messenger of Allah and staying away and avoiding the innovation. قال هذا الإمام رحمه الله, this great imam, he goes on to mention, حدثنا علي بن حجر قال حدثنا بقية بن وليد عن بحير بن سعد عن خالد بن معدان عن عبد الرحمن بن ماذا عن عبد الرحمن عن العرباد بن سارية رضي الله تعالى عنه أنه قال. This noble imam, he mentions that his sheikh Ali ibn Hujr narrated to him, that his sheikh Baqiyat ibn Walid narrated to him, on the authority of Bahir ibn Sa'd, on the authority of Khalid ibn Ma'dan, on the authority of Abdul Rahman ibn Amr al-Salami, on the authority of the noble companion Al-Urbad ibn Sariya radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, who mentioned, وَعَظَنَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ يَوْمًا بَعْدَ صَلَاةَ الْغَدَاتِ مَوْعِدَةً بَلِيغًا. He said, one day after the morning prayer, the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam turned to us and he addressed us with a very eloquent, a very detailed admonition, so much so that the ضَرَفَتْ مِنْهَا الْعُيُونَ وَوَجِلَتْ مِنْهَا الْقُلُوبُ, that the eyes began to shed tears and the hearts began to be filled with the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَقَالَ رَجُلٌ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ كَأَنَّ هَذِهِ مَوْعِدَةُ مُوَدَّعٍ فَمَاذَا تَعْحَدُ إِلَيْنَا. So a man from the companion stood up and he said, Ya Rasulullah, is as if this is a farewell admonition, is as if you're about to leave us, Ya Rasulullah. فَمَاذَا تَعْحَدُ إِلَيْنَا. So what do you advise us? What do you command us? What do you instruct us with, Ya Ibadah, Ya Rasulullah? فَقَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. So the Messenger of Allah, he mentions, أُوْسِيكُمْ بِتَقْوَى اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. I instruct you, I implore you, I advise you with the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَالسَّمْعِ وَالطَّاعَ, and listening and obeying. وَإِنَ عَبَدٌ حَبَشِي, even if the one who is entrusted with your affairs, over your affairs, is a black man or a servant from Africa, from Abyssinia, وَالسَّمْعِ وَالطَّاعَ, then listen and obey. فَإِنَّهُ مَنْ يَعِشْ مِنْكُمْ فَسَيَرَى اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. For indeed, whoever lives a long life from amongst you, he's going to see many differences of opinion, much argumentation, much quarreling, much bickering. فَمَاذَا وَإِيَّاكُمْ وَمُحْدَثَاتِ الْأُمُورِ, and beware of those newly introduced novelties in Islam. فَإِنَّهَا ضَلَالَةٌ, for indeed all of them are misguidance. فَمَنْ أَدْرَكَ ذَلِكَ مِنْكُمْ فَعَلَيْهِ بِسُنَّتِي وَسُنَّةِ الْخُلَفَاءِ الرَّاشِدِينَ الْمَهْدِيِّينَ عَدُّوا عَلَيْهَا بِالنَّوَاجِذِ الْحَدِيثِ. Then the Messenger of Allah goes on to mention, and whoever from amongst you lives a long life and reaches this time here, then let him hold on to my sunnah and the sunnah of those rightly guided khulafa that come after me. عَدُّوا عَلَيْهَا بِالنَّوَاجِذِ, hold on to my sunnah and to their sunnah, which are molar teeth. هذا الحديث كما سمعتم هو عند الإمام الترمذي والإمام ابن ماجة والإمام الألكائي رحمهم الله. This hadith, as we mentioned, is collected by the great Imam al-Tirmidhi, also by Imam ibn Majah, also by Imam al-Lalakai, in his Shara Usul I'tiqadi Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah rahimahum Allah ta'ala. تصوروا هذا الحديث العظيم. Ponder, ya ibadallah, and reflect over this tremendous occurrence. صلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم صلاة الغداة مع أصحابه الكرام رضي الله تعالى عنهم أجمعين. The Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام prayed the morning prayer with his companions. May Allah be pleased with them. وهذا يدل على فضل الصلاة. And this by itself points to the virtues of the prayers. يا عباد الله. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم. As Allah the Mighty, the Majestic, he mentions. إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر. الآية سورة العنكبوت. Allah Ta'ala says, verily the prayer, it forbids, it protects, it defends the person from falling into those evil and lowly actions, those evil and wicked deeds, ya ibadallah. إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر. سورة العنكبوت. Verily the prayer, it prohibits the individual from falling into those lowly, despicable, wicked actions, ya ibadallah. فالذي يذنب كثيرا عليه بالصلاة. So the one from amongst us, ya ibadallah, who constantly makes error and constantly sins. وَمَن مِنَّا لَا يُقْتُ أَحْيَانًا. And who from amongst us does not fall into sin from time to time. وَالَذِي يُذْنِبُ كَثِيرًا عَلَيْهِ بِالصَّلَاةِ. And the one who constantly sins and constantly matter and constantly makes error, it's upon him with the matter, with the prayer. عَلَيْهِ بِالصَّلَاةِ. It's upon him to make the salah, ya ibadallah. يَقُولُ النَّبِيُّ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ مَنْ صَلَّى الْبَرْدَيْنِ دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ. مِنْ حَدِيثِ أَبِي مُوسَى الْأَشْعَرِي عِنْدَ الْبُخَارِيِّ مُسْلِمٍ رَحِمَهُمَ اللَّهُ. And the Messenger of Allah mentions, whoever prays the two cold ones, the two cold prayers, is going to enter into the Jannah. And this hadith is narrated by Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, collected by al-Bukhari and Muslim rahimahullah. قال الإمام النووي رحمه الله معنى البردين. And the great Imam of the Shafi'i Madhab, Abu Zakariya Yahya ibn Sharaf al-Nawawi, he mentions معنى البردين, the meaning of the two cold prayers, as-subhu wal-fajr, as-subhu wal-asr. الصبح والعصر. That the meaning of the two cold prayers is the morning prayer, al-fajr, and the afternoon prayer, the asr. ويقول النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام من ترك العصر فقد حبط عمله. ونعوذ بالله. والحديث عند الإمام البخاري من حديث بريدة. And the من حديث بريدة. And the Messenger of Allah mentions, whoever leaves off the asr prayer, whoever abandons the asr prayer, then he has lost all his actions. And this hadith is collected by البخاري. Narrated by بريدة. يا عباد الله انظر إلى الصلاة. فالذي يريد أن يحافظ على أعماله كلها لا بد من العصر. So the one who wants to safe keep his actions and preserve his actions and maintain his actions, it's upon him to preserve his salah, especially the asr prayer. من ترك العصر فقد حبط عمله. Whoever leaves off the asr prayer has lost all of his actions, ya ibadallah. ويقول النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام أرأيتم لو أن نهرا بباب أحدكم يغتسل منه كل يوم خمس مرات ما هل يبقى من درنه شيء. And the Messenger of Allah, one time he asked the companions a question, and he said to them, if there's a river at the door of one of you, in which the individual, he bathes in this river 5 times a day, هل يبقى من درنه شيء. Is there going to remain any traces of dirt, any traces of filth upon this individual? قالوا لا يبقى على درنه شيء يا رسول الله ومن درنه شيء يا رسول الله. The companion said, O Messenger of Allah, no, there will not remain any traces, any filth upon this individual who bathes in the river in front of his door 5 times a day, يا عباد الله. فقال النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام فذلك مثل صلوات الخمس. So the Messenger of Allah said, this is the similitude of the 5 prayers, ya ibadallah. يَمْحُ اللَّهُ بِهِنَّ الْخَطَايَا. Al-Hadith. By the 5 prayers, Allah Ta'ala erases the sins. By the 5 prayers, Allah Ta'ala removes the sins and the shortcomings, ya ibadallah. وَهَذَا الْحَدِيثُ عِنْدَ الْإِمَامِ الْبُخَارِ وَمُسْلِمْ مِنْ حَدِيثِ أَبِي هُرَيْرَةِ. And this hadith is collected by Bukhari and Muslim from the narration of Abu Huraira رضي الله تعالى عنه. أَيْنَ نَحْنُ مِنَ الصَّلَاةِ يَا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ. Where are we, ya ibadallah, from the salah? أَيْنَ نَحْنُ مِنَ الصَّلَاةِ. Where are we from the prayer, ya ibadallah? يوجد في زماننا الآن nowadays يا عباد الله لا يعبد الله سبحانه وتعالى إلا في يوم واحد وفي شهر واحد ونعوذ بالله وهذا يخالف سنة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم nowadays most of the Muslims يا عباد الله فاختاروا بلد ما and you choose the country you wish يا عباد الله or مدينة ما or the city that you wish or مسجد ما or you choose the masjid that you wish في زماننا الآن nowadays يا عباد الله most of us only worship Allah one day يوم الجمعة most of us only worship Allah in one month يوم ماذا شهر رمضان in the month رمضان فكأننا نسينا أن رب رمضان هو رب الشوال it's as if we have forgotten that the Lord of Ramadan is the Lord of Shawwal وكأننا نسينا أن رب الجمعة هو رب الاثنين and it's as if we have forgotten that the Lord of the day of Jumu'ah is also the Lord of the Monday, ya ibad Allah. Wa yaqulu an-nabiy alayhi salatu wasalam. And the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam also mentions, من صلى الصبح فهو في ذمة الله من حديث جنيد بن سفيان عند البخاري and the Messenger of Allah he mentions whoever prays the morning prayer whoever prays the morning prayer then he's in the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the hadith of Bukhari narrated by جنيد بن سفيان رضي الله تعالى عنه فقال وعظنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم So he went on to mention that the Messenger of Allah bestowed upon them a very detailed admonition. ضربت منها العيون and the eyes began to shed tears and the حمادة ووجلت منها القلوب and the hearts began to become filled with the fear of Allah. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله والحمد لله الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن ولا أما بعد فيقول العرباد بن ساري رضي الله عنه So the companion of the Messenger of Allah العرباد رضي الله عنه He mentioned وعظنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم موعظة بليغة يوما بعد صلاة الغداء That one day after the Fajr prayer or the morning prayer the Messenger of Allah bestowed upon us a very detailed a very eloquent admonition ضربت منها العيون ووجفت منها القلوب So much so that the eyes began to shed tears And the hearts began to be filled with the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فقال رجل يا رسول الله كأن هذه موعدة مودع فماذا تحد إلينا؟ So the man he stood up and he said, O Messenger of Allah, it's as if this is a farewell. It's as if you're about to leave us. It's as if this is a reminder or instruction that you're about to leave, يا رسول الله. فماذا تحد إلينا؟ So what is it that you instruct us with? فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أوصيكم بتقوى الله For the Messenger of Allah said I advise you with the fear of Allah والسمع والطاعة and listening and obeying فإن عبد حبشي even if the one that's in charge of your affairs is a servant from Abyssinia فالسمع والطاعة then listen and obey فإنه من يعيش منكم فسيرى اختلافا كثيرا For indeed whoever lives a long life from amongst you he's going to see many differences of opinion many argumentation many quarreling or much different وإياكم محدثات الأمور and beware of those newly introduced novelties in Islam فإنها ضلالة for indeed there are misguidance فمن أدرك ذلك منكم and whoever reaches this time from amongst you فعليه بالسنة then let him hold on to my سنة وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين and the sunnah of those rightly guided خلفاء that come after me عدوا عليها بالنواجذ hold on to my سنة and their سنة which are molded teeth ماذا فلهذا ففي هذا الحديث العظيم نستفيد العبد أو يستفيد العبد عدة أمور from this tremendous hadith the servant of Allah can benefit many benefits يا عباد الله ضربت منها العيون from these benefits their eyes begin to shed tears and their hearts began to become filled with the fear of Allah هذا يدل على أنهم كانوا يتدبرون معاني القرآن وكانوا يتدبرون معاني سنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم this shows that they eyes, matter that their eyes began to cry, that the tears began to come forth, and their hearts began to become filled with the prayer of Allah. This shows that they used to ponder and reflect with regards to the meaning of the Book of Allah and the meaning of the Hadith of the Messenger of Allah. Qira'atuhum ma kanat qira'atina. Their recitation of the Book of Allah, their reading of the Book of Allah, and their reciting of the Book of Allah was not like our recitation, ya ibadallah. Naqra'u kitab Allah wa hal nu'minu bima naqra'u minhu. Many of us, we read the Book of Allah, but do we believe in what we read, ya ibadallah? Naqra'u kitab Allah wa hal nu'minu bima naqra'u minhu. We read the Book of Allah, alhamdulillah, but do we actually believe in what we're reading, ya ibadallah? Dharafat minha al'uyun. Their eyes began to shed tears. وَهَذَا يَدُلُّ عَلَىٰ أَنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يَفْأَمُوا مَعَانِ كِتَابِ اللَّهِ. And this shows that they used to understand the meaning of Allah. فَلَا يَأْتِ الدُّمُوعُ إِلَّا بَعْدَ تَدَبُّرٍ. For indeed, tears will never come forth except after pondering and reflecting the text that you're reading, or pondering and reflecting the text that you're listening to, ya ibadallah. Wa wallahi la ya'ti dumu' illa ba'd al-fahm. And indeed, tears will never come forth except after understanding what you're reading, except after understanding what you're listening to, ya ibadallah. Kayfa tabki ala shay'in la tafham? Al-jawab la yumkin. How can the person cry over something that he does not understand? الجواب لا يمكن. The answer is, this is not possible, ya ibad Allah. يقول الله جل في علا. Allah Ta'ala mentions in the Quran, أفلا يتدبرون القرآن أم على قلوب أقفالها. Al-Ayah, Surah Muhammad. Allah Ta'ala, he says, do they not ponder and reflect over the Quran, or do they have locks or seals over their hearts? Surah to Muhammad, ya ibadallah. Undu ila kitabi rabbina. Listen to the words of our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. Afala yatadabbaruna al-Quran. Do they not ponder and reflect over the Quran? Man minna yatadabbaru kitab Allah, wa man minna yatadabbaru sunnata rasulillah alayhi salatu salam. Who is going to reflect and ponder the words of his Lord? And who is going to reflect and ponder the words of the Messenger of his Lord alayhi salatu wasalam? ويقول النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام من حديث أبي هريرة عند البخاري ومسلم. And this hadith is collected by Bukhari and Muslim also, narrated by Abu Huraira. قال لا يلج النار رجل بكى من خشية الله. The Messenger of Allah, he mentions that the hellfire will never touch an individual who cries from the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The hellfire will never touch an individual who cries من خشية الله, out of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فقال النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. So the Messenger of Allah continues, أوصيكم بتقوى الله. I advise you with the fear of Allah. قال العلماء, the scholars of Al-Islam, they mention, تقوى الله مفتاح لكل خير. The scholars of Al-Islam, they mention that the fear of Allah is the key of all goodness, ya ibadallah. لا يعمل عبد عملا خيرا قط إلا على أصل هذا العمل تقوى الله. No individual from the servants of Allah performs an action of goodness except at the root of that action, ya ibadallah, he feared Allah Ta'ala. He had the consciousness of Allah. He had the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ويقول الله subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah the Mighty and the Majestic, he mentions, إِنَّ بَطْشَ رَبِّكَ لَشَدِيدٌ. Al-Ayah, Surah Al-Buruj. Allah Ta'ala, he says, verily the punishment, the torment of your Lord is severe. Surah Al-Buruj. وَيَقُولُ تَعَالَى وَيُحَذِّرُكُمَ اللَّهُ نَفْسَهُ. Al-Ayah, Surah Al-Imran. And Allah Ta'ala mentioned, and Allah frightens you from himself, and Allah makes you afraid of himself. Surah Al-Imran. وَيَقُولُ النَّبِيُّ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ. And the Messenger عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ mentions, أَكْرَمُ النَّاسِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ مِنْ حَدِيثِ أَبِي هُرَيْرَةَ عِنْدَ الْبُخَارِيِّ وَمُسْلِمٍ. And the Messenger عَلَيْهِ mentions, the most honorable of you in the sight of Allah is the one that has the most taqwa. ليس العرب, not the Arab. ليس الأعجمي, not the foreigner. ليس النساء, not the women. ليس الرجال, not the men. أكرم عند الله أتقاكم. The most honorable of you in the sight of Allah are the ones that have the most taqwa, ya ibad Allah. إذا توجد أمنا وأختنا وهي وحدها في مصلنا الآن ولها تقوى الله وتقوى الله أقوى من تقوى لنا فهي أكرم عند الله. If one of our beloved mothers or one of our beloved sisters or our beloved daughters right now, and she's by herself there in the area of the women, and she has the most taqwa of Allah, then she's the best one in the sight of Allah. She's the most honorable one in the sight of Allah. As the Messenger of Allah, he mentions, أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. The most honorable one of you in the sight of Allah is the one that has the most taqwa, the one who fears Allah Ta'ala the most. عندما يتكلم يتقي ربه تعالى. When he speaks, he fears Allah. عندما يجلس يتقي ربه. When he sits, he fears Allah. And ما يأكل طعاما ماذا يتقي الله. When he feeds himself, he fears Allah. And ما يعبد عبادة يتقي الله. When he does an action of worship, he fears Allah. هو أكرم عند الله. He's the most honorable one in the sight of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. ويقول النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام والسمع والطاعة. Then the Messenger of Allah continues, and that you hear and obey. وإن عبد حبشي. Even if the one that's entrusted with your affairs is a servant, a black servant from Abyssinia, then listen and obey. فإنه من يعيش منكم فسيرى اختلافا كثيرا. For indeed, the one who lives a long life from amongst you, he's going to see many differences of opinion, many quarreling, much argumentation. فحل النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام لنا في هذا النزاع. But the Messenger Allah gave us the cure when we argue, gave us the cure when we differ. هذا الإمام يقول هذا وهذا الإمام يقول هذا هذا المذهب يقول هذا وهذا المذهب يقول هذا. This Imam has an opinion, he says such and such. While this other Imam has another opinion, he says such and such. This madhab says this and this other madhab says that. الحل لنا أن نرجع إلى كتاب الله ونرجع إلى سنة رسول الله. The cure for all of this difference of opinion, يا عباد الله, that we have to come back to is leave off all of these statements of this imam and that imam and this madhab and that madhab and return back to the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah. كما قال تعالى, as Allah Ta'ala mentions, فإن تنازعتم في شيء فردوه إلى الله والرسول إن كنتم تؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر. الآية سورة As Allah Ta'ala says, if you differ amongst yourselves in anything, if you differ amongst yourselves in anything, then return it back to Allah and the Messenger of Allah, if it is you truly believe in Allah and the last day. Surah An-Nisa. فَقَالَ النَّبِيُّ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ. So the Messenger of Allah continues, فَمَنْ أَدْرَكَ مِنْكُمْ ذَلِكَ. So whoever from amongst you reaches this time, فَعَلَيْهِ بِالسُّنَّةِ. Then hold on to my sunnah, ya ibad Allah. أَيْنَ نَحْنُ مِنَ السُّنَّةِ. Where are we from the sunnah, ya ibad Allah? Al-an fi zamani al-an, akthar al-muslimin al-yawm yastahiyun an nudhira sunnah nabiyyihim alayhi salatu wasalam. Nowadays, most of the Muslims of today, we are too shy and we are too ashamed to put forth the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam. Ayna nahnu min tatbiq as-sunnah. Where are we from the implementation of the sunnah of the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam? Yadhunnu al-kuffar anna sunnah خاصة للنساء لأنهم يظن ماذا لأنهم يرون من نسائنا سنة النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام ولكن أين السنة من نسبة إلى الرجال. Nowadays the disbelievers, they say to the Muslims on national TV, it looks like the sunnah of al-Islam is only for the Muslim women, for indeed they are the only ones that you see the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah upon. What about the men, ya ibad Allah? What about the men, ya ibad Allah? As-sunnah laysa lil-nisa faqat, as-sunnah lil-nisa wa lil-rijal. The sunnah of the Messenger of Allah is not only for our women, but it's for the men also, ya ibad Allah. Yaqul Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah Ta'ala mentions, وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاهُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. Surah Al-Hashr. Allah Ta'ala says, and whatever the Messenger of Allah gives you, then take it. And whatever he prohibits you from, then stay away from it. Surah Al-Hashr. وَالسُنَّةُ وَحْيٌ مِنَ اللَّهِ. And the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah is revelation. فأنت تزعم الآن يا أبا عبد الله أن سنة محمد وحي من الله. الجواب نعم. Perhaps a person is going to say, so you mean to tell me, Abu Abdullah, that the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah is revelation from Allah? الجواب نعم. The answer is yes. فاسمعوا إلى كلام ربكم. Don't take my word. Listen to the words of your Lord سبحانه وتعالى. يقول جل في علاه, as Allah Ta'ala says, وما ينطق عن الهوى إن هو إلا وحي يوحى. سورة النجم. Allah Ta'ala says, and he, meaning Muhammad, does not speak from his own desire. He does not speak from his own accord. That which he speaks from is revelation that has been sent upon him. سورة النجم. فعلينا علينا يا عباد الله أن نطبق سنة النبي. ثم ماذا؟ To implement the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah. لا نستحي من اليهود والنصارى. Do not be shy in front of the Jews and the Christians. هم لا يستحيون أمامنا. ماذا؟ بدخانهم. They are not shy in front of the Muslims with their smoking and their intoxications. فلماذا نحن نستحي أمامهم بعبادة الله سبحانه وتعالى؟ So why are we shy in front of them to worship our Lord سبحانه وتعالى؟ نترككم يا عباد الله بآخر كلام وهو من أحد من سلف الصالح. So we leave you lastly, يا عباد الله, with one of the narrations from our Salaf. ولعله من Yusuf ibn Asbalta. And this narration is from the noble Imam. His name was Yusuf ibn Asbalta. قال قولا عظيما. He said a tremendous narration, يا عباد الله. أحدكم احفظوا هذا القول. At least one of you memorize this statement, يا عباد الله. Yusuf ibn Asbalta, رحمه الله. He went on to say, كان أبي قدريا. He said, my father followed the madhab of القدرية. وهم نخلي إمامكم إن شاء الله تعالى نعلمهم ماذا يعتقدون القدرية إن شاء الله تعالى. ما عندنا وقت الآن. So we'll let our Imam, our beloved Sheikh, next time or in the class or so, teach the community what does the قدرية believe, as we don't have enough time right now. At any rate, قال كان أبي قدريا. He said, my father was from the madhab of القدرية. وأخوالي كانوا روافضا. And my uncles on my mother's side, they followed the madhab of الروافضا, the Shia, the روافضا. فأنقذني الله بسفيان. But Allah saved me by sending me سفيان الثوري. أي كان هذا الإمام على السنة. فأنقذه الله تعالى بإرساله إليه سفيان الثوري. Meaning that Allah Ta'ala, this man was between his father who believed in al-Qadariyya and his uncles who believed in the Rafida, but Allah sent him a great imam of the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam. وقال Abdullah ibn Shawdab, in another narration, ya ibadallah, by the name Abdullah ibn Shawdab, he said, إِنَّ مِنْ نِعْمَةِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى عَلَى الْحَدَثِ وَالْأَعْجَمِي أَنْ يُوَفِقَهُمَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَالِمٍ مِنْ أَهْلِ السُّنَّةِ. This great Imam, and we'll stop here inshallah ta'ala, this great Imam Abdullah ibn Shawdab, he said that from the blessings of Allah upon the young man or upon the foreigner, meaning the non-Arab, upon the non-Arab, is that Allah makes it successful for him, for both of them. He guides to them a scholar from أهل السنة يا عباد الله. يعلمهم السنة النبي. Teaching them the sunnah of the messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام. فإذا عندك من الله تعالى زوجة على سنة نحمد الله تعالى له واشكر هذه المرأة. So if Allah bless you with a wife and this wife is on the sunnah, then thank Allah and thank this beloved woman. وإذا من الله تعالى عليك يا أختي برجل من أهل السنة فأحمد الله واشكري هذا الرجل. And if Allah bless upon you, O beloved sister, oh my beloved mother, he bestows upon you a husband and this husband is on the sunnah, then thank Allah and thank this beloved husband. وَإِذَا مَنَّ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَلَيْكَ مِنْ أَصْحَابِكَ وَاحِدٌ مِنَ السُنَّةِ فَأَحْمَدُ اللَّهُ وَأَشْكُرُوا هَذَا صَاحِبٌ. And lastly, if Allah bestows upon you with a companion from the sunnah, then thank Allah and thank this companion. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يعلمنا ديننا جميعا. And we ask Allah that He teaches all of us our religion. وأن يرجعنا جميعا إلى سنة النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. And that He makes all of us upon the sunnah of the messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام. اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. Oh Allah, we ask that you give us the good in this life and the good in the hereafter, and you protect us from the hellfire. Allahumma atina fi dunya hasana wa fi akhirati hasana wa qina adhab an-nar. Oh Allah, we ask that you give us the good in this life and the good in the hereafter, and you protect us from the hellfire. Qumu ila salatikum yarhamukum Allah. Stand up for your prayer. May Allah bless and honor each and every one of you. Wa jazakum Allahu khayran wa nasabtu fa min Allah wa naqtatu fa min nafsi. Anything that I said that's correct is from Allah. Anything I said incorrect is from myself. Wa jazakum Allahu khayran. نقوم إلى صلاتكم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاة. أقمت الصلاة أقمت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
أقيموا صفوفكم. Alanya Road Street. Alanya Road Street. فلا تختلفوا. Do not be divided. فتختلف قلوبكم or your hearts will be divided. Sisters, make your rows straight. وحاذوا بين المناكب والعقاب. And join between your shoulders and your ankles. وأكرمكم الله. أقيموا صفوفكم. Align your rows straight. Align your rows straight. Allahu Akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين قل يا الذين هادوا إن زعمتم أنكم أولياء لله من دون الناس فتمنوا الموت إن كنتم صادقين ولا يتمنونه أبدا بما قدمت أيديهم والله عليم بالظالمين قل إن الموت الذي تفرون منه فإنه ملاقيكم ثم تردون إلى عالم الغيب والشهادة فينبئكم بما كنتم تعملون يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون فإذا قضيت الصلاة فانتشروا في الأرض وابتغوا من فضل الله واذكروا الله كثيرا لعلكم تفلحون وإذا رأوا تجارة أو لهوا انفضوا إليها وتركوك قائما قل ما عند الله خير من الله ومن التجارة والله خير الرازقين الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمدا الله الله أكبر الله الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تلهكم أموالكم ولا أولادكم عن ذكر الله ومن يفعل ذلك فأولئك هم الخاسرون وأنفقوا مما رزقناكم من قبل أن يأتي أحدكم الموت فيقول رب لولا أخرتني إلى أجل قريب فأصدق وأكن من الصالحين ولن يؤخر الله نفسا إذا جاء أجلها والله خبير بما تعملون. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم.